Yes, the operation was successful. Moses finally unplugged the internet, so Trisha Paytas can no longer make hundreds of tweets an hour about Ethan Klein. But during Trisha's brief hiatus, Ethan Klein had a chance to respond to her on TikTok. He makes one with the caption, "I was not offended by these jokes, but Trisha's recent claims that I was trying to intentionally trigger and SH her is so hypocritical and so low."
Ethan purposely triggering me, trying to trigger me on multiple occasions. It was a lot of things, from sexualizing my skincare product. Like, you know, I was just like that. I was like, you know.
Come on, have sex with me.
Wow, really is just all about how much you really, your mind is one place.
That's all I asked.
No.
That is true.
You could have.
This is such, yeah, that's a lie. Like, we know that's a lie. Like, whatever.
No, I definitely don't want to. No desire to fuck you. Or be
I know you're lying.
About,
fans? Your, our collab?
Bro. I wouldn't do that for $1 billion.
Like a showering video? You wouldn't just shower with me, like, taking a shower? That's sexual.
Not even for $10 million.
Could you imagine if we just stood next to each other naked in the shower, just like doing a shower? Like,
why do you,
hair?
Why do you think anyone would pay for that? If Ela took your advice and moved on, would you make a move on me?
Yes.
Oh, God.
So is that what you were trying to do the whole time?
Yes, my sister didn't know about this, but we ended up paying for Ethan and Ela, which is crazy because he takes that 5% and VIP tickets to Disneyland is not cheap.
What? What is wrong with these people? I swear to God, that's Trisha's sister made a TikTok saying that we didn't pay for Disneyland for her birthday. Okay, I begged Moses, begged him to let us pay. According to the Trisha's family, this 5% that I was taking for production fees could cover the national debt at this point. What can't the 5% cover? I'm supposed to be paying for Disney. I begged them to let us pay. Trisha, please, you guys, stop. This is so unnecessary. It is so ridiculous. And it is honestly ruining our family. I please need you guys to stop. This is not cute or funny or necessary at all.
So as Ethan mentioned, that TikTok he reacted to came from Trisha Paytas' sister. The TikTok is now deleted, but luckily I was able to get a copy of it to show for you guys, and it's in response to this tweet from Ethan Klein that we covered in the last video. Here is what she said.
So you can pause to read this, but I wanted to make it known that he didn't even take the time or effort to watch my sister's video. She was just doing a trigger warning to people that had SA because she was talking about the candlestick incident. So this Disney trip was actually planned for my sister's birthday. It was me, my mom, and Moses, and that was it. I know that they were at a family event at Ethan's house, and Ethan incidentally invited himself to our family surprise, and we paid for him. Ethan and Ela did not pay for their VIP ticket to Disneyland, and there's more. Yes, my sister didn't know about this, but we ended up paying for Ethan and Ela, which is crazy because he takes that 5% and VIP tickets to Disneyland is not cheap. And I don't know why he felt compelled to ask me and my mom or bring it up in the situation that how we felt about her having a candlestick up her, you know what? It made us very uncomfortable, especially we had just such a fun day. And it was really disgusting. I think that he wanted the shock value, but I think that he forgets that we're family at the end of the day. And I was not appreciative of that, especially since we paid for everything. Even we paid for the dinner he wanted to pay for. He kept on saying, "I'm gonna pay for a dinner."
And this one is for the people that think that I solely work for my sister or needed a job at age 3. I actually work for myself. I have my own business as a spicy accountant, and I highly doubt that H3 could afford me, so.
So after this TikTok was made, Def Noodles reposted it and captioned it on Twitter by saying, "Clap back!" Trisha Paytas' sister Callie responds to Ethan Klein's TikTok responding to Trisha. Callie says Trisha's family paid for Ethan's tickets to Disney, and it got very uncomfortable when Ethan brought up Trisha's sexual assault to her family during the trip. Ethan Klein quote tweets him and says, "Now Trisha's sister is coming after us. No mention of the fact that we literally begged Moses to let us pay. Please just stop this. So, so stupid and ruining our family." So of course after this tweet was made, Trisha started responding to it on Twitter. She tweeted out, "Ruining our family. Being dramatic as fuck. No, Ethan. You are a lying, condescending asshole. Literally, that's all I've said and I'll keep saying. You keep dragging everyone in to deflect that my issue is with you and how you run business. Texting Moses about stuff that happened literal years ago. Deflecting from the issue that happened last week between you and me. If I was so awful and you still can't get over stuff from years ago, why even start a podcast with me and call me your bestie? It's like shit hit the fan last week. And now all of a sudden, let's bring back all the monstrosities Trish has been in the past 2 years. Shall I bring in clips of you saying nasty stuff about my clip before I ever mentioned it, or even went on your show? It's sad because I don't hold that shit against him. I thought we were past that because we did a fucking podcast together. Like, what? And now you're texting Moses about stuff that happened in like 2019? What? Ethan clearly has some resentment and issues with me for a while now. Talk to me about it. Why stress out Moses and other people that none of this has anything to do with? You lied to the staff to make me look bad. You aired an episode that you saw me as being rude. You never looked out for me from a business standpoint. You did a whole video bringing up my past bad behavior just to knock me even lower. Only half pertaining to the here and now. The only person ruining your family is you. I have no issue with anyone else but Ethan. Not the staff, not anyone. Ethan was condescending. Ethan lied. Ethan manipulated and twisted my words. No one else. I even said in my videos it's better I leave Frenemies so we have a chance at still having a personal life, which I've always enjoyed. He's attacking everything I've ever done wrong, but let's not be pointing too many fingers when there's a lot more than can be pointing back at you. I never thought there'd be a bigger drama queen than me, till I started reading Ethan's Twitter this past week. Like, ruining our family? Calm down, bro. There's no sides. There's just you being drama as usual. Reddit is not reality, bud. Mercy responds to Trisha by saying, "All Trisha tried to do was quit, yeah? Why is it so dramatic? Just let the person quit if they want to quit." Trisha quote tweets him and says, "This. Like, damn. He really been harvesting bad feelings from when he said all was forgiven. Let's not use that F word so freely if we just gonna use it to be vicious later on." Danielle responds to Trisha by saying, "What the actual fuck? Blaming him to stress out Moses? Girl, if you had any consideration of your fiancé, you wouldn't have put out so much personal drama that involved your fiancé's family." Trisha quote tweets them and says, "Once again, I've only talked about Ethan. Ethan is the only shitty person over there in my humble opinion. Ethan tried to convince Moses I've tried to ruin his life. Like, give it a rest. Why? Why are you bringing up the past that doesn't involve you? Bring up stuff we have worked through? That sounds like ruining our family. It's low and dirty. What's the point? All this because I quit and now I'm the enemy? Like, fucking shit. It's a shitstorm. He knew I was quitting. He knew I didn't want to fire the crew. Like, I'm trying to move past, but interfering with my personal life? Stop. Just stop. Like, read the room. The internet is on your side, Ethan. What are you fighting so hard to prove? You won the battle of who's in the wrong. You won. Now you are just trying to, like, tap dance on my grave? What is the fucking point? Ruining our family. My favorite Ethan drama queen Klein quote. I literally just don't like you at the moment for the way you can't take an ounce of responsibility for maybe not being perfect in our dynamic. He can't admit to one fault. But yeah, let's bring others into it. Jamie responds to her by saying, "You have never once taken responsibility in this situation either, queen." Trisha quote tweets her and says, "Lol, I literally can't even count all the things I've apologized for and openly talk about that I did wrong. Like, should I list them all again? I fucked up on so many levels." Sunny responds to Trisha by saying, "All this because you set a boundary." Trisha responds, "This. Like, a situation wasn't good for me anymore. I left. I told him it's done. I made a video because I could see the audience upset with me. I'm not here to make anyone angry. I want to make people happy, and if I'm not doing that, I need to step back." Maria responds to Trisha by saying, "At this point, I'm gonna believe this is for publicity. It's too much, and it's going on too long." Trisha responds, "I fucking wish it was. This is the craziest nightmare I've ever been in, and it literally stems from absolutely nothing. Like, this does not feel like a reality." Hannah Burner tweets out, "I think Trisha Paytas and Ethan Klein are both in the wrong. Now please get off Twitter and post a new Frenemies. Title it, Just In. Trisha and Ethan hire a therapist. The enemy's in. Frenemies 40. Trisha responds, "Be great if he could admit to one fault. But no, there's nothing more he could have possibly done. I have constantly apologized even for that episode, but it was never enough. He had to go and throw in shit that was forgiven and okay with him when we were doing the show. But now that it's over, time to throw it in my face, remind my fiance, and blast it all over the internet. Knowing I've changed from that person, like I have, it's not an off and on switch. I still fuck up, but fuck, I'm trying my best. Like I have this shit thrown in my face. I'm just like, what the fuck? Ethan grasping at anything and everything right now to continue this. Like avoiding the main point that he lied to the staff, and lied to me that the night after the podcast after everything was fine. It's deflection. I don't have any sympathy for Ethan. I do, however, feel horrible for everyone else he's spewing this bullshit to, especially in real life. He obviously hasn't truly let go of our issues in the past. Stuff I fucked up on, and for that, I am sorry. I feel like me staying around, he was holding that anger inside, and like damn, just letting it all out now that it's really over. In the court of public opinion, Ethan, you won. You are the winner. Do you have to keep nitpicking everything I've ever done wrong? We get it. It's out there. I talk about it. I own up to it. Like what? What do you want from Moses to leave me? Do you think we don't have conversations about literally everything that happens? Why are you trying to convince him that I'm trying to ruin his life from stuff we worked really hard to heal from? It's weird and creepy. Stop. Someone then responds to Trisha, but despite me getting this tweet within 48 seconds, the response was somehow deleted. Regardless, she responds to it by saying, because he's telling the internet I'm ruining his family. So I'm saying I have no issue with anyone but him, and my issue isn't that deep. Moses doesn't have an issue with anyone, so he's inciting more hate my way from an already existing hate mob. Ethan lives on Reddit. He is well aware of all the intense hate I'm receiving. I'm accepting of this hate. It's literally what I signed up for, but saying, she's ruining my family, is igniting more pitchforks for no reason, because it's not true. After all of this, Ethan makes a couple more memes about the situation. He tweets out, about to end world hunger real quick with my 5%. He then tweets out this funny image of the richest people in the world, showing Bill Gates for Microsoft, Jeff Bezos for Amazon, and Ethan Klein for 5% extra Frenemies podcast. The source of this meme, of course, being from Reddit. Hassan Piker responds to him by saying, is this true, Ethan? To which Ethan responds, yes. You want some money? And that's about it for the situation so far. But as many of you guys know by now, this is part 5 within about a week, so a part 6 will probably eventually exist, because Trisha and Ethan cannot stop fighting with each other. So if you don't want to miss the continuation of this, be sure to subscribe with notifications on. Thank you so much to my channel members for supporting the channel, in particular Scrubby who's donated $100 a month. But with all that being said, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.